thanks. A bit wet today. Ah, this is why I love the countryside. Need to get some fuel, so I've set the nav 6 to the nearest petrol station. So it is handy sometimes if you're riding along and you just want to quickly just stick an address in there quickly while you're riding along. It's perfect. This one's a little bit more technical, like to input it, so you might have to pull over and do it. This one you can just quickly, especially petrol, very easy, just hit the petrol button and it shows you the closest ones. That's all I did, and it said the nearest one 2 miles, so let's get there. I think that's the Malvern Hills over there in the distance. I don't think you can see it today, it's a bit hazy. more view goals. Let's just ride into all the views that we see. Yeah. Come to the Cotswolds. Have a ride around. See what you think. If you haven't been already, most bikers have probably been here. But most bikers just stick to like the Foss and the towns and the villages. But I love coming out in these little country lanes because there's so much to see out here. It's just so quiet. Come and spend the day out here. Just explore, ride down lanes, tracks, find what you like. Petrol station 2 miles away. Winchcombe, ancient Saxon borough. Please drive carefully through our town. Yes, sir. Would you live in a place like this? Would I? Could I even afford it? Doubt it. These places are very expensive. This is good. The new hill start assist thing. So I've got that on now. You see the H there? Just means it's locked on. So I can literally, if I want, look, put it in neutral. There you go, I'm in neutral now. Hands off the wheel and I'm on a hill. And it's still there. Brilliant. All these little things just help, don't they? Especially for short ass like me. Busy in Winchcombe. So you come from those country lanes and you end up on one of these sort of busier places, and it's, you just want to get back down those country lanes again, away from civilization. Things like this. So we should have a petrol station somewhere along here, hopefully. 25 miles left in the tank. Okay, yep, let's go. By the way, you've got Sudley Castle here. Anyone likes castles? Lovely day for a walk. Here we go. Perfect. Okay, so where are we now? Let's have a look at the map. We're all fueled up. What time is it? Not even 12 o'clock yet. We've already had so much fun. Let's see where we are. Okay, I know where we'll go next. We'll head, as we're in the Cotswolds, we'll head over towards Bourton On The Water. Shortest way. So we go shortest route to Bourton On The Water. Shortest. How far have we got to go? Not even that far from here. Okay. So, we're heading towards Bourton On The Water now. Let's have a look how far it is. Miles, hardly anything, but we've got it set on shortest route, so hopefully it'll take us down some fun lanes. Excellent. It is taking us down these back ways, which is good, so we get off the main drag. Rushley Lane. I swear some of these walkers just look at you like you're dirt. I don't even go fast. Great Cotswolds views. That is what it is. Yeah, I'm standing up. She was probably looking at me standing up thinking, who the hell does he think he is? Is that way. We're 6 miles from Bourton On The Water. I don't know if any of you know Bourton On The Water. I used to come here regularly as a child for days out. It's a fine example of a Cotswold village or town, and you'll see when we get there. It's normally packed. I think they bring buses of tourists here. If you haven't been there, get the family together and go there on a nice sunny day, because it is really good. There's a river going through the middle of it, you'll see. The Hollow Bottom. Nice. Those clouds look a bit ominous. So if you look at this, where we are now, imagine, it's 14th century, that's how long they've been here. Farmer's arms. I preferred his legs actually. Bourton On The Water. 5 miles. This, and all my days, there's definitely rain over there. I can see it coming down. Never mind. If we get wet, we get wet. No bother. When I bought my last bike, the 1200, I spent so much that I just skimped on the gear a bit. I got a really, really good helmet, a brilliant helmet, Sherry Hornet, and the rest of the gear, I've got the matching set IXS, which is good gear. I mean, I've heard people saying their Alpine Star jackets and stuff are leaking when it rains and stuff. This is IXS, and I'm telling you, IXS gear has done me proud. It's very warm. I go out in the winter still, and it's still really warm inside. It's waterproof, comfortable, but it's getting on a bit now. 6 years old or 5 years old. I think I need to change it. Probably need a new helmet as well. So I'm thinking I want to get a Showy Neotech helmet, and then I might get the Alpine Stars set, or I don't know, because everyone seems to wear Klim. What does everyone think of Klim? Or Danies? What's everyone's opinion on that? What shall I get? What can you recommend? Showy Neotech 2. The only thing putting me off getting that is because I've already got the Senna Bluetooth headset, and that comes with the fitment for the new one. And I want to be able to use this, and someone said you can't put it on the side, you have to put it around the back because there's no room for it, because the fitment's there for the new one. What do you guys say? What other helmets would you recommend? I wouldn't mind one that you can flip up. What are your views on that? Let me know. And also, what gear do you reckon? I was looking at some of the Klim gear. Whoa, the price is like major. So I can remortgage the house and get Klim gear if you want. What do you recommend? Well, this car's wet, so I'm assuming he's just come through the rain, and I'm probably about to hit it. 2 miles from Bourton On The Water, and there's water going to be dropping on us in a minute, I can see. Let's see how busy Bourton On The Water is today. Usually it's just rammed, I just ride straight through. When it's sunny, the grass area by the water is mobbed. And rain. Oh, I'm definitely getting rain on me. What's a bit of rain anyway? Okay, it's definitely had some rain here. And this is the start of Bourton On The Water. So you've got this river down here, look. And then it goes all the way through the village, which you're about to see. Looks actually quite high, as you can see there, look. There's the start of the river. And it goes right down through the houses, through the lovely Cotswold village of Bourton On The Water. I think it's a village, yeah. But on a sunny day, this is packed here. When I brought my kids, they were even paddling in the river. Okay. I don't care about the rain because I've got all waterproof gear on. So rain if you want to. So this is Bourton On The Water. Oh my days, this is what I mean. Look at this. Traffic jams in the village. Yep. You'll see when we get down here. It opens out into a nice big wide open space. And you can sit by the river. There's a maze where the kids can go and play in near here. There's a little model village. Nice little fish and chip shops and ice cream. Place to get a sandwich. And it's just full of like tourists. And Tesla drivers, look. Let's go. Fish and chips. Bikers. Here we go. Did they bring brollies? Did everyone bring brollies? And as you can see, there's the river going through, look. And little bridges. Nice little pubs to eat in. And coffee shops. Tourists everywhere. Come on. Come on. Look, bikers are nice. We are nice. Give a little rev for the kid. So usually everyone's sitting on this grass here. Obviously not today. It's a washout. Oh, there's a good bakery here, look. Cornish Bakery. Want to get yourself a pasty? smells good. I think it's actually hailing. Oh my god, it is. Actually snowing. Or hailing. Winter's finally arrived. Summer was good. Summer was really good. Lasted quite a while. Let's head out of this weather. Oh, that's where all the bikes are, look. They're not mad like me. And then if you walk along here, there's all sorts of things. Look, there's the river again, look. And then in there, there's like a sort of bird sanctuary place. And you can pay to go in. It's really nice, actually. It's like a zoo thing. Keep walking along and there's the maze. Take the kids in there. It's great fun. I think I'm heading into the black.